Hello and welcome. My name is Henning Kalwa, and I'm the founder of Imagine Health. Today's conversation is one I've been looking forward to. For the last two decades, I've met hundreds of families, patients living with spinal cord injuries, and many of them have traveled abroad in search of hope. I was instrumental in setting up programs in Thailand and Mexico to provide invasive subcutaneous spinal neuromodulation for spinal cord injury patients. So I've seen both the possibilities and the limitations of those approaches. That's why I believe xStep represents a major leap forward. xStep is a non-invasive home-use neuromodulation device developed by a company called SpineX, co-founded by Dr. Reggie Edgerton, often referred to as the godfather of spinal neuromodulation. With me is Parag Gad, co-founder and CEO of SpineX, and one of the key people behind this breakthrough. Parag, welcome. It's a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you, Henning. It's a pleasure to be here and be really excited to share with you all the journey that we've had with SpineX and the evolution of xStep to where it is today, offering meaningful solutions and therapies for individuals living with traumatic spinal cord injuries.
For those hearing about xStep for the first time, which is likely, what exactly is it and what makes it so different from other spinal stimulation technologies?
xStep is a non-invasive, non-surgical, wearable neuromodulation device that is designed specifically for individuals living with neurological conditions. Now, you've probably heard of other stimulation devices that are used to manage pain. Unlike those off-the-shelf or traditional devices, xStep is really designed for individuals living with neurological conditions to offer therapies and treatments to treat the condition at the source. xStep delivers a very novel electrical waveform that is targeted towards the neurons present in the spinal cord that help restore communication between the brain, spinal cord, and muscle, essentially rewiring the entire system that is impacted due to the spinal cord injury. It is designed for home use and can easily be delivered in the convenience of a person's home, allowing these individuals to continue therapy without having to be limited to multiple hospital or clinical visits or the need for a surgical implant and allow therapy to be continued on. Most importantly, the therapy is delivered non-invasively, does not require a surgery. It has been designed based on keeping these individuals in mind and has been backed by clinical data. As I mentioned earlier, there are multiple spinal cord stimulation devices on the market, and these were designed primarily to manage pain and have been around for multiple decades. xStep, on the other hand, has been designed specifically to restore function in individuals living with neurological condition. And this includes autonomic function, including bladder, bowel, sexual function, cardiovascular function, reduction in spasticity, as well as restoring sensory and motor function.
You like to describe xStep as a kind of pacemaker or hearing aid for the spinal cord, which I think is a really powerful way to explain it. Could you walk us through what you mean by that in simple terms, especially for someone who may not have a medical background?
What happens when a spinal cord injury occurs is the injury leads to loss of communication between the two halves of the nervous system, above and below the injury. The regions of the spinal cord below the injury are still present. Those are still pretty much alive. They're not dead. They're just dormant due to the messages from the brain not being able to reach the neurons in the spinal cord below the level of injury. When xStep is active, it works with two very basic functions. First, like a pacemaker runs your heart, this xStep device is able to run the neurons in the spinal cord so that it can generate function. Second, like a hearing aid amplifies the sounds so that it can reach your inner ear and you can hear what is being said to you, the xStep amplifies the weak nerve signals communicating between the regions of the spinal cord, allowing the brain to hear what the extremities or the periphery is trying to tell the brain, thus restoring bidirectional communication and restoring function.
Makes total sense. I know xStep builds on previous devices like SCONE, which earned the US FDA breakthrough device designation. Can you walk us through the evolution from the lab with Dr. Edgerton to where we are today?
Dr. Reggie Edgerton, who, as Henning mentioned earlier, is fondly referred to as the godfather of modern spinal neuromodulation, has been working in this field for now coming up upon 55 years. So it's been his life's journey that has brought to where we are at today. This builds on basic research conducted in his lab by his team members, including myself, for the past 50 plus years, right from early animal studies, non-human primates, all the way through clinical trials that we've been conducting. SpineX first developed the SCONE device, which was meant to treat neurological conditions, including autonomic functions in individuals living with a spinal cord injury, stroke, or MS, which then evolved into the SCIP device, which was designed to treat the pediatric indication in children living with cerebral palsy. xStep basically builds on these platform technologies to create a unified solution that addresses multiple neurological conditions. It is designed based on strong clinical clinical trials and data from these clinical trials, and is backed by real life stories and real life feedback that we've received from individuals.
You mentioned Dr. Reggie Edgerton. Well, can you tell us a little bit about his role about not only founding SpineX, but in shaping the entire field of spinal cord stimulation as we know it today?
Reggie was one of the first people that really identified the role of spinal cord in controlling movement. And this dates back to the early 70s when animal experiments were conducted and the whole concept of central pattern generation was identified, and identifying neurons in the spinal cord that are firing to generate movement. So this goes back, 50 plus years, and it's been an evolution in the science itself, where these basic concepts were first understood, which then led to our understanding of how the spinal cord can be controlled to restore function in individuals living with a spinal cord injury. And then more recently, understanding concepts of neuroplasticity, where you don't necessarily need to have the device on the entire time, and that the brain and spinal cord are plastic and can learn based on the inputs that it is receiving. So if you train the spinal cord to walk, if you train the spinal cord to stand, the brain and spinal cord can learn how to walk and stand respectively. These strong scientific concepts led to the formation of SpineX and for the basis of all the clinical trials that we've been running and the foundation of the products.
You touched on it already, but what sets your team, your research, and your approach apart in this neuromodulation space?
One of the key elements in this is the team that is supporting the technology. And what's interesting to note is world over, if you consider every single individual that is working in the field of spinal cord neuromodulation, or even spinal cord injury for that matter, has been influenced by Reggie's learnings and Reggie's teachings. Over the last 50 plus years. He's mentored pretty much everyone that is in this field for the past 50 years. That being said, the technology, like I mentioned earlier, is based on strong clinical science, strong clinical data. We have never been biased by technology, and what we're trying to achieve has been based on what the data tells us and what the clinical results are implying. That's one of the key reasons why we believe we've been successful, and we are at the top of the pyramid, if I may say, because we're essentially allowing the data to drive our thinking.
And everything you do is for one purpose only, and this is the patient. So let's talk about this. What kind of spinal cord injuries are best suited for this approach? And how do upper and lower level injuries differ in terms of response?
Every single individual that has a spinal cord injury is unique and different. What is hard to appreciate for someone on the outside that does not live with a spinal cord injury is that a spinal cord injury is the most traumatic condition that an individual lives with that causes loss of function in every single organ system downstream from the injury. Having said that, based on what we've known so far in the clinical trials and the data, xStep is definitely highly successful in restoring function in not only individuals living with an incomplete spinal cord injury, but is also able to restore meaningful function in individuals living with a complete spinal cord injury. For individuals that have a cervical or upper spinal cord injury, it is successful in restoring function to the degree of improved trunk function, being able to sit upright on their own, improvement in meaningful hand and arm function so they can start use their hands more independently, being able to restore activities of daily living so they can eat on their own. They don't require assistance in transferring from a bed to a chair or from a chair to a car, as well as perform basic activities in and around the house. For individuals living with a thoracic or a lumbar injury, it's been successful in restoring assisted stepping, for example, being able to stand on their own, being able to restore sensation to the lower extremities, as well as improvement in bladder bowel sexual function with improvements such as the fewer number of catheters needed through the day, being able to catheterize based on how full that bladder is, i.e. Restoring sensation of bladder fullness, as well as being able to have a complete and more robust bowel movement without the need for suppositories or digital stimulation.
Wow. Now the big question, what kind of improvements have you seen? Of course, every patient is different. You said it. But can you give us an overview of what might be possible based on existing research and clinical observations?
Yeah, that's a great question. Based on what we know so far, one of the big advantages of the non-invasive approach is the ability to stimulate different regions of the spinal cord based on what a patient requires. For a person with a cervical spinal cord injury that is keen to improve hand and arm function, trunk function, we're able to neuromodulate the cervical spinal cord and restore trunk function so they can sit upright on their own without the need for back support. They can sit in a car without being strapped in. A lot of the individuals that we worked with often describe themselves as a spaghetti while seated in a car and needing multiple straps to hold them in place, otherwise they're going to fall over. Versus after neuromodulation therapy, they're able to sit upright on their own and are stable and can drive around. Being able to restore balance while standing, being able to reduce spasticity in their lower limbs so that they can sleep at night more peacefully, as well as improvement in sensation of bladder fullness so they can catheterize based on how full the bladder is rather than the clock say it's 4 hours and it's time for me to catheterize. And one of the critical changes that we have noticed is reduction in the number of urinary incontinence episodes. These individuals are able to have fewer leaks, and especially because they don't have sensation. And if they leak earlier prior to therapy, even if they would have leaked, they wouldn't be able to realize that they've had a leak and would have to touch and feel for it. But due to both restoration of sensation as well as a reduction in incontinence episodes, you see a huge improvement in their quality of life as well as the quality of life of their loved ones.
And just as important, what do we know about safety so far, especially for home use?
Based on all the clinical information we have so far, all the trial data, we've observed no serious adverse events. This particular technology has been tested in multiple clinical trials around the world with hundreds, if not thousands of individuals that have been part of these trials. And all of them have reported clinically meaningful improvement without any adverse events reported. The technology has been designated by the US FDA as a breakthrough device, which essentially highlights that the improvement in function is greater than the current standard of care that's offered to them, offering us an expedited pathway towards a regulatory approval. And in terms of risk factors for a person living with a spinal cord injury, autonomic dysreflexia, skin breakages, UTIs are common occurrences. All of our trial data so far suggests that with this therapy, we're able to also have a direct positive impact in reduction of some of these other comorbidities, co-conditions that SCI individuals have to normally live with. And due to the non-invasive nature of this therapy, we're able to avoid any normal risk of a surgical intervention that a person would have to live with if they were to consider an implant.
Yeah, I think being home use ready and non-invasive is the key here. Some patients with spinal cord injuries may consider invasive spinal cord stimulation in the hopes of recovering function, and they may want to go abroad to gain access to these opportunities. How does xStep compare to those options, both medically and practically?
As I mentioned earlier, I think one of the big advantages is the non-invasive nature, and that not only improves the safety profile of the device, not needing a major neurological surgery, but also because of the non-invasive nature, we're able to modify and move the electrodes up and down the spine as needed, providing a lot more flexibility and options for these individuals that live with a spinal cord injury. Due to the complex nature of the injury itself, these individuals have multiple needs, and the ability to modify the electrode combination and stimulation protocols provides us with that flexibility to address those actual needs. It's a much lower risk pathway in terms of the risk profile being far lower compared to a surgical intervention. Practically, it's a safer option, it's a cheaper option, much more accessible, and allows you to use the device at home without multiple clinical visits.
I tend to agree, Parag. We've talked about the research, the progress, and the potential, but many people watching may have been told this is your new normal. Accept it. what would you tell them or their families right now?
One of the key messages that I want individuals to take home is that we want to shift the new normal. XStep is designed to restore function to a degree that has not been seen earlier, and we're at the forefront of making it happen. While we want to, individuals to have hope and expectations, our technology is again driven by very, very strong clinical data, and all the data so far points to the fact that the new normal needs to be reestablished. So for every individual, the new normal will be reestablished with technologies like XStep, and we do expect that to occur very, very soon.
And finally, for those who are ready to explore the new normal, when and how can someone actually access XStep?
We expect XStep to be available on the market in a matter of months, and our collaboration with ImagineHealth is specifically intended to make that happen. It's not a question of if or when, but it's a question of how quickly can we get to it. So we're really excited to bring XStep to market and hope that XStep would have a positive and direct impact on millions of individuals around the world living with a spinal cord injury.
Parag, thank you for everything you've shared today and for the work you and your team continue to do. To everyone watching, we're not promising miracles, but XStep by SpineX is a science-backed, non-invasive option that may help to improve the quality of life of many people who do not want to accept the status quo. If you or someone you love is living with a spinal cord injury and wants to explore whether XStep might be a fit, we'd be honored to support you. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you in our next conversation.